Noting like that. Khat writing is a special field itself. It's a field you go into and you study. Kitaba is very serious. Qawa'id al-imla' is a big chapter to study. Al-kitaba, people, it's a fun, it's to study. Qawa'id al-imla', the principles of how to write, it's a field. Shaykh al-Islaam Taymiyyah rahimahullaah, he knew. He also knew maths. He was extremely good in maths, rahimahullaah ta'ala. Wa hafiz al-Qur'an, he memorized the Qur'an. Wa aqbala ala al-fiqh, he turned towards fiqh. Wa qara'a al-arabiyyati, he read the Arabic language on who? Ibn Abdul Qawi, al-Mardawi, he read on him. You guys know Ibn Abdul Qawi al-Mardawi, the Manzumatul Adab that we looked into and we studied? Huh? The author of it, Ibn Taymiyyah read on him. ثُمَّ فَهَمَهَا, he understood the Arabic language very well. Look at this, pay attention. He didn't, when he learnt it, look at him. He looked into the book, Kitab Sibawayh. Sibawayh. Huh? He looked into his book. He looked into his book. And you guys, Al-Imam Sibawayh rahimahullah, yudrab bihi al-mathal. Sibawayh, when we studied Ibn Hisham's Qatr al-Nada, what did we say? إِذَا قَالَتْ حَدَامِي فَصَدِّقُوهَا فَإِنَّ الْقَوْلَ مَا قَالَتْ حَدَامِي صَحْ. Ha, they used to, if Sibawayh say something, itself was a hujjah according to the grammarians. قَالَ Sibawayh فَقَطْ, leave it. Ha. So Imam Sibawayh rahimahullah, he read his book. حَتَّى فَهِمَ فِي النَّحْوِ, until he understood it. Isti'ab, he comprehended it. It went into his system. And not us, anyone who studies Ajrumiyyah. And then adds Qatr al-Nada with the Sharh of Ibn Hisham and understands it very well. To us is what? He's from the Nuhat, from the grammarians, from the ulama of the language. And Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, وَأَقْبَلْ عَلَى التَّفْسِيرِ إِقْبَالًا كُلِّيًّا حَتَّى حَازَ فِيهِ قَصَبُ السَّبْقِ. He turned toward what? After, look at, brothers, how when a person enters the house from the right place, everything works good for him. Everything has a way, has a manhajiyya, has a methodology. You take its methodology. What did he do? He learned to read, he learned to write. He also studied what? He memorized the Qur'an. He then went to fiqh, and then he went to the Arabic language. And all of it, he went to its people. Took it from its people. And he understood it. And then it gave him ahliyyah. It gave him the authority. And allowed him to go to the big books and study it and comprehend it. Rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'a. Then he turned towards what? The greatest book that a person can ever turn towards. The book of Allah. And when he turned towards it, Ibn Taymiyyah didn't turn towards it with a heart which was wholeheartedly. Iqbalan, kulliyan. He turned towards the book of Allah wholeheartedly. Hatta haza fi qasab al-sabq. Until he proceeded. He passed everybody who came. Rahimahullah. Walidhalika, I tell you this. Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, if you look at his knowledge, how vast it is. And I tell you this, wallahi. Every single body who came after Ibn Taymiyyah, Al-Qasi wa-Dani, the one who loves him and is a supporter of Ibn Taymiyyah, and the person who goes against Ibn Taymiyyah and is in opposition to the Shaykh, I can assure you one thing, all of them, they dipped from his ocean and they took from his river. Rahimahullah, they took something from him. They benefited from him. He became the stepping stone for anybody who wanted to learn ma huwa, what is it, manhaj al-salafi fi al-i'tiqad, in matters of aqa'id. Ibn Taymiyyah was what? Issues of tafsir. What did the salaf say in this issue? In its Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, he brought it there. Rahimahullah. And what? He would place everything fi mawdi'i, in its place. Rahimahullah. What did he also learn? Wa ahkama usul al-fiqh. He mastered usul al-fiqh. And these are ulum, ikhwani. They are sciences. Wallahi, when a person learns it very well, the religion becomes very easy for him to take on board. Everything becomes in its right place. And I spoke about that before, when I spoke about usul al-fiqh and mustat nahw al-nahw, when we're studying it, the importance of it, when we're speaking about mabadi' kulla fannin. All of this, brothers, when did he do this? وَهَذَا كُلُّهُ, all of that which we mentioned that he did, rahimahullah, all of those ahadith books he studied, all of those scholars he took knowledge from, all of that, he took that when? وَهُوَ بَعْدُ إِبْنُ بِضْعَ عَشَرَ سَنَةً. The Shaykh rahimahullah ta'ala was in between the age of 13 to 19. all of that. Good. فَانْبَهَرَ أَهْلُ دِمَشْقَ The people of Dimashq, they were mind-boggled, gobsmacked regarding the affairs of Ibn Taymiyyah. What? مِنْ فَرْطِ ذَكَائِهِ How fast his memory was. وَسَيَلَانِ ذِهْنِهِ And how pure, smooth his mindset was. His comprehension. وَقُوَّةُ حَافِظَتِهِ And how strong his memorization was. وَالسُرْعَةُ إِدْرَاكِهِ Pay attention to that. And how fast he could transmit what he needed. Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, he was able to use the ayah he needed in the right place. He also had the ability to use the hadith fi mawridih in the place that he would need it for. He needed it here, he would know how to say. Some people will say, which ayah? Look for the ayah. La. He will straight away come out of his mouth, rahimahullah ta'ala. Listen to this story, it will amaze you. A scholar of the time of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, who was in Halab. Halab, he came to Dimashq. He came to Dimashq. And he said, when he came to Dimashq, he asked the people about an individual who he was looking for. He said, Sami'tu, I heard fil biladi, where I am, in Halab, I heard of a boy. Bistabi, yuqalu lahu Ahmad ibn Taymiyyah, I heard this boy, Ahmad ibn Taymiyyah, I heard about him. Ibn Taymiyyah is young. I heard, وَأَنَّهُ سَرِيعُ الْحِفْدِ That his memorization is fast. And I came, قَاسِدًا لَعَلِّ أَرَاهُ So I can see him. I want to see him. This man from the guy he asked, he said, okay, listen. He comes from the nursery, he's going to take this road right now. He's going to tread on this path. Wait for him and you'll see him. He sat down and he waited. Ibn Taymiyyah came walking by. He grabbed him. Ibn Taymiyyah, he had with him a big wooden lawh in Arabic. Even in my country, Somalia, one of the ways they make us memorize the Qur'an is to write on the lawh. Which is that the person, he takes the Qur'an memorization and he also has to write the Qur'an on his lawh. He washes it, he cleans it and he writes it on there. That's how they made us memorize the Qur'an. So you're writing the Qur'an and you're also memorizing the Qur'an. The teacher takes the lawh from you, he doesn't even look at it because he's hifz is taqib. And next morning you wash it and you write it again. He had on it some writing. So he wiped it off, he wrote things for him, he said look at it. He gave him a couple of minutes to look at it, Ibn Taymiyyah. And then he took it from him, he said read it on me. And he read every hadith he wrote for him, every information he wrote for him in the same order in which he wrote it in. He read it on him, exactly. That's how he was, rahimahullah, as a young kid, before he even became Ibn Taymiyyah. And Imam Muhafiz Abu Abdullah al-Dhahabi, and Imam al-Dhahabi, what did he say about him? He said about Ibn Taymiyyah, نَشَأَ شَيْخُ تَقِيُّ الدِّينَ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ فِي تَصَوُّنٍ تَامٍ وَعَفَافٍ وَتَأَلُّهٍ وَتَعَبُّدٍ وَاقْتِصَادٍ فِي الْمَلْبَسِ وَالْمَأْكَلِ وكان يحضر المدارس والمحافل في صغره ويناظر ويفحم الكبار ويأتي بما يتحير منه عيان البلد في العلم فأفتى وله 19 سنة بل أقل وشرع في الجمع والتأليف من ذلك الوقت وأكب على الاشتغال ومات والده وكان من كبار الحنابلة وأئمتهم فدرس بعده بوظائفه وله 21 سنة وتقدم في علم التفسير والأصول وجميع علوم الإسلام أصولها وفروعها ودقها وجلها وله خبرة تامة في الرجال وجرحهم وتعديلهم ومعرفة بفنون الحديث والصحيح والسقيم مع حفظه لمتونه الذي انفرد به فلا يبلغ أحد في العصر رتبته ولا يقاربه وهو عجيب في استحضاره واستخراج الحجج منه وإليه المنتهى في عزو إلى الكتب الستة بحيث يصدق عليه أن يقال كل حديث لا يعرفه ابن تيمية فليس بحديث واشتهر أمره وبعد صيته في العالم He said about Ibn Taymiyyah, he said Ibn Taymiyyah grew up in a very chaste and a place of worship. he was moderate in his clothing and his eating. He said he used to come to the circles of knowledge and the gatherings of the ulama and the people of knowledge whilst he was a young kid. He would debate and he would silence the elders who were greater older than him in age. He would come with matters that will confuse the people of knowledge of his land. He gave fatwa and used to give fatwa. وَلَهُ تِسْعَ عَشَرَةَ سَنَةً. He was only 19 years of age. بَلْ أَقَلُّ. Rather, he was less than that, the Habib said. وَشَرَعَ فِي الْجَمْعِ وَالتَّأْلِيفِ. He said he embarked on combining, authoring from that time. And he said, وَأَكَبَّ عَلَى الْإِشْتِغَالِ. And he put his head down in busying himself in this field of authoring and writing and educating and teaching the people. He said his father died, and his father was from the great scholars of the Hanabila, the Hanbali madhab. Ibn Taymiyyah taught after his father, and he was only 21 years of age. He said he went forward and he went deep into the knowledge of tafsir and usul and all of the fields of the religion, its sub-branches and the fundamentals of it. So he's praising his aqeedah and he's praising his understanding of fiqh. وَدِقِّهَا وَجِلِّهَا. Those which were detailed and those which were what? Those which were apparent and everyone could see. He said, وَلَهُ خِبْرَةٌ تَامَةٌ فِي الرِّجَالِ. And he also had vast, strong understanding of the men. This chain of narration, he knew the men very well. He also knew وَجَرْحِهِمْ وَتَعْدِيلِهِمْ, whether they were criticized or they were praised, and who criticized them and who praised them, he knew it. وَمَعْرِفَةُ بِفُنُونِ الْحَدِيثِ. And he also understood the science of hadith. وَالصَّحِيحِ وَالسَّقِيمِ. He knew the authentic hadith and he knew the weak hadith. مَعَ حِفْظِهِ. With his memorization on لِمُتُونِ الَّذِي انْفَرَدَ بِهِ. The narrations which each book is singular in. So you'll say, for example, Rahu Imam Rahu al-Bukhari wa Muslim, wa lafdhu li Muslimin. That this word is singular for Imam Muslim only. Or this wording, only Abu Dawud narrated this. Or this Muslim, this wording, Fulan only. He knew that very well, the mutun of the hadith. All of this I'm reading is Zahabi speech. He said, فَلَا يَبْلُغُ أَحَدٌ فِي الْعَصْرِ رُتْبَتَهُ. No one of this era reaches his level. No one. وَلَا يُقَارِبُ. And no one's close to him. وَهُوَ عَجِيبٌ. He said he was fascinating. فِي اسْتِحْضَارِهِ. How he can bring whatever he needed. How he can bring the evidences for himself. It was عجيب in it. وَاسْتِخْرَاجِ الْحُجَّةِ مِنْهَا. And then to extract the proof from it. Meaning, he always was fast in the dalil and the madlul. The evidence and how to extract the evidences. He was very sharp. He would say, قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. Hey, what's the proof in that? All the points he wanted from him, he'll get it out quickly. وَإِلَيْهِ الْمُنْتَهَى. He said, it finished at him. فِي عَزْوِ إِلَى الْكُتُبِ السِّتَّةِ. How he brought back every hadith to the books. Like he would, Bukhari said this, Muslim said it, Tirmidhi said it, Ibn Majah said it. لِذَلِكَ. In his Majmu' al-Fatawa, it's amazing sometimes, because he wrote so many of his letters, Ibn Taymiyyah wrote so much of his letters, because of questions that he was asked. His Majmu' al-Fatawa, fatawat he was giving. Al-Rasail, he wrote. Sometimes he would say, Rawahu al-Bukhari, Bukhari narrates this hadith, and I think it's him. I think this scholar of hadith narrated this hadith. I think he narrated it, said. And if you go and you find it, that's it. It is as he said it. Many places you see that. بِحَيْثُ يَصْدُقُ عَلَيْهِ أَن يُقَالَ. Imam al-Dhahabi says that it is correct. Huh? And it's sahih that it said every hadith that Ibn Taymiyyah doesn't know, فَلَيْسَ بِحَدِيثٍ. It is not a hadith. That could be said. But here we have to put brackets in there and say what? إِلَّا أَنَّ الْإِحَاطَةَ لِلَّهِ. Except to comprehend everything like that, it's only for Allah. We can't let that unrestricted. And we don't do ghulu. We don't go extreme in those who we love. Na'am, he was an alim and he knew it very well. But ihata, all of the narrations that Ibn Taymiyyah didn't know, that is another hadith, this we would say, illa anna al-ihata lillah. Only Allah is the one who everything he knows. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. There could be hadith he didn't know, but what does that show you? What did that show you? And Imam al-Dhahabi, when he says that, who is he? Sahib al-Sir ala min nubala. Lisan al-Mizan. Sorry, Mizan al-I'tidal. Sorry, Lisan is the Ibn Hajar. Mizan al-I'tidal. Sir ala min nubala. Rijal? Men? Dhahabi rahimahullah ta'ala. He is the scholar in this field. He is the scholar of hadith. The book of Imam Abu Abdullah al-Hakim al-Nisaburi, his book. Al-Mustadrak. He then tatabbu of it and followed it up. And a hadith which he considers that they are from the Shurut al-Bukhari and Muslim. Huh? And Imam al-Dhahabi followed it up to Hakim and he said he's incorrect in this. So men, hadith, Ibn Dhahabi is the man. Ibn Hajar used to drink Zamzam water for him to teach him the men. The way Allah taught Dhahabi men. Ibn Hajar would drink water, Zamzam water, with what intention? He would say, oh Allah, the way you taught al-Dhahabi, the men, teach me. Ya Allah. Ibn Hajar would say that. And Imam al-Dhahabi saying this about Ibn Taymiyyah. That he was strong in men. Hadith is his field. All of that he said, there was no one like him in this issue. Nobody. And no one is even close to him. بحيث يصدق على أن يقال كل حديث لا يعرف ابن تيمية فليس بحديث واشتهر أمره. His matter became famous. Well known by everybody. وبعد صيته في العالم. His praise, his respect, his love, it spread around the world. رحمه الله تعالى. الحافظ المزي رحمه الله. إمام المزي, look what he said about him. ما رأيت مثله. I never saw like Ibn Taymiyyah. أبو الحجاج المزي. صاحب what? The author of what? تهذيب الكمال في معرفة الرجال. That I spoke about before. The book that deals with the six books of hadith. Each narrator, his life, his biography, where he was born, you know, who took from him, who did he take from, if he took from this person, was he strong, and if he didn't take from him, like matters pertaining to every narrator of the six books of hadith. Abu al-Hajjaj wrote a book on that. He's saying, مَا رَأَيْتُ مِثْلَهُ, I never saw anyone like him. وَلَا رَأَى هُوَ مِثْلَ نَفْسِهِ إِبْنُ تَيْمِيَةَ, did not see anyone like himself as well. I never saw it, and nor did Ibn Taymiyyah. وما رأيت أحدا أعلم بكتاب الله وسنة رسوله ولا أتبع لهما منه. He said, I never saw anyone more knowledgeable in the book of Allah and the Sunnah than Ibn Taymiyyah. And I also never saw anyone who followed them both more than Ibn Taymiyyah. I never saw that. This is who? Al-Hafiz Al-Mizzi. Hafiz Al-Mizzi rahimahullah ta'ala. Al-Allamah ibn Zamlikani. Zamlikani, he's considered from what? One of the enemies of Ibn Taymiyyah. Who hated Ibn Taymiyyah. Who had hate towards him. He's considered from A'da'u Shaykh. When you could criticize the people's, those who hated Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. It said that he said, اُقْتُلُ ibn Taymiyyah وَدَمْهُ عَلَىٰ عُنُقِي. Kill Ibn Taymiyyah and his blood is on my neck. The hate he had for him. Na'am. He said about Ibn Taymiyyah, كان إذا سئل عن فن من العلم ظن الرائي والسامع أنه لا يعرف غير ذلك الفن. This is what he said. He said, if he was asked about a field from the knowledge, the person who's looking and listening to him would think that he doesn't know except this field. Any field that he was asked. You look at Ibn Taymiyyah and listening to him, you would think to yourself, this is the field he specialized in. This is the one he knows, nothing else. You see, وَحَكَمَ أَنَّ أَحَدًا لَا يَعْرِفُ مَثْلَهُ. And the person would give a ruling that he doesn't know except this. وَكَانَ الْفُقَهَا. The jurists of his time, Ibn Taymiyyah's time, they would do what? He's talking about Ibn Taymiyyah. The jurists of other madhabs, مِنْ سَائِرِ الطَّوَائِفِ, إِذَا جَلَسُوا مَعَهُ, when they sat with Ibn Taymiyyah, إِسْتَفَادُوا, they would benefit from him. فِي مَذَاهِبِهِمْ مِنْهُ, their own madhabs from him. The Hanafi would come and he would learn the usul al-Hanafiyyah from Ibn Taymiyyah and the aqwal within the madhab, the qawl which is rajih and the qawl which he would tell them. And the qawl which is mukhtar, and the qawl which is asah, and the qawl which is sahih, and the qawl which is mu'tabar, he would tell them from the madhab. Ibn Taymiyyah, each madhab. The people of that madhab would benefit from him. في مذاهبهم منه. ما لم يكونوا قد عرفوا قبل ذلك. That which they didn't know before that. They didn't even know that. They would learn it from him. رحمه الله. ولا يعرف أنه ناظر أحدا فانقطع معه. It was said. This is who? Zamlakani. He said, and it is not known that he argued and debated with a person and he became silent from him. Or he lost what to say. He didn't know what to say anything. It never happened. ولا تكلم في علم من العلوم. And he never spoke about a matter from the matters of the religion. سواء كان, whether that was من علوم الشرع, whether it was matters pertaining to the religion. It doesn't matter. He did not speak in a science, a knowledge, whether that matter was knowledge pertaining to the religion. أم غيرها, or even other than it. It's like philosophy. علم الكلام. Matters weren't religious. He didn't speak about it. إِلَّا أَفَاقَ فِيهِ أَهْلَهُ وَالْمُنْتَسِبِينَ لَإِلَيْهِ. He would surpass and he would beat those people who claimed they specialize in that field. Like the philosophers who immersed themselves in that field of علم الكلام الفلسفة. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah would pass them in the issues of philosophies more than the philosophers. رحمه الله تعالى وكانت له اليد الطولة في حسن التصنيف. And he said he had a hand, a long hand, meaning he was very far in the issues of authoring. Ibn Taymiyyah would sit down and write a book between Dhuhr and Asr. Sometimes a book would reach him, like the book that reached him regarding Al-Qadr. A man, he spreaded a shubha in the issue of Qadr. Couple of lines. Shaykh al-Islam sat down and it was approximately, I think, if I'm not wrong, 100 lines. He replied back to him. He turned away, looked for a pen and paper, and he wrote straight away. The people thought that أَنَّهُ يَكْتُبُ نَثَرًا, that he's going to write it in a normal book, just to refute his points. But because what was sent to him was written in a poetic form, he replied back with a poetic form. All of that من استحضار قلبه, from the top of his head. استحضار, all of it. من ظهر القلب, from the top of his head. So he was very good at writing. وجودة العبارة, and the way his usage of his terminologies and his words. والترتيب والتقسيم والتبيين, and how he categorized, clarified, huh, matters. واجتمعت فيه شروط الاجتهاد على وجهها, and the conditions of اجتهاد in its reality, in the way it should be, was present in Ibn Taymiyyah. He was a mujtahid mutlaq, unrestricted mujtahid. Any madhab, he could do ijtihad on it. Any nazila min al-nawazil, he could do fatwa on it, this issue. He can give a jurisprudent ruling, rahimahullah ta'ala. ولذلك, even the mujtahideen, if you read the books, such as the book written by Muhammad Amir al-San'ali, rahimahullah, in his book Irshad, the mujtahid, sometimes there are those who do ijtihad, but they have to go back to their references and their books. They can do ijtihad in any matter, but they don't have it with them. So they have to sit down, research the issue, tackle the issue, look at everything, bring it together, and then the fatwa comes out from him. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah was not from those. Rahimahullah ta'ala. Min rahr al-qalb. From the top of his head, he will do ijtihad on a matter. He didn't require any preparation or looking into the issue or, la, not at all. Rahimahullah. So this is ujuba, a fascination that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولذلك, it was said that the way he used to write and the way he used to author, he never was able to read his own handwriting. If he wrote, he will never know he wrote it. And he couldn't read his own writing. ولذلك, there was an individual who was متخصص. He specialized in the books and the writing of Ibn Taymiyyah at the time of Ibn Taymiyyah. And I want all of you, inshallah, to do a homework and find out who that person was. He learned and he understood what Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah's writings were. That's how fast he used to write. It was hard to. And ولذلك, even the manuscripts of Ibn Taymiyyah's works are very hard to be read. ولذلك, I sat with one Shaykh I sat with one Shaykh who told me that he met Shaykh Ahmad al-Ansari, rahimahullaah, rahmatan wasi'ah. Shaykh Ahmad al-Ansari. Shaykh Ahmad al-Ansari. I met one Mashaykh, min al-Mashaykh al-Kibar, who told me he met Shaykh Ahmad al-Ansari. Shaykh Ahmad al-Ansari, rahimahullaah, may Allah enter him Jannat al-Firdaus. He was from those scholars who specialized